Hello students, so today we are going to discuss string functions. In today's video, we will discuss what are the string functions available in SQL. So these are the following string functions available with it. First one is UCase. In case of UCase, you may use upper function also. Both will work similar. So what it will do, it will give you the string written in capital letters. Okay. It will convert all the letters in uppercase. Similarly, the next one is LCase. It will convert the letters in characters in lowercase or small letters. And you may use lower function instead of LCase also. Third one is mid function. So it extracts character from the string. I will explain you. Let us first discuss only. I will explain you by giving example also. The next one is length function. It returns the length of a string. Length of a string means it will count how many characters are present in a particular string. The next one is left function. It returns leftmost specified characters of string. For example, if you want that from left side of a string you want 4 characters, then you have to use left function. And opposite to that is right function. It will give you the rightmost specified characters of a string. It means you have to specify the numbers of character, and that many number of characters will be extracted from the right side of the string. Similarly, INSTR function, it will search for a particular substring in the string, and it will return you the position of the first occurrence of that particular substring in the original, in the existing string. Ltrim, rtrim and trim function. For example, in a string, if some leading space is there and you want to truncate that, if you want to remove that leading space, then you have to use ltrim function. Similarly, if at the end of string any spaces are there, also known as trailing spaces, then that can be removed by using rtrim function. And if you want to remove both the spaces, that is the leading space and trailing space, then trim function may be used. Remember, none of these functions can be used to remove the in-between spaces. If you want to remove then this in-between space between any string, then these functions will not work. Okay, this will either remove the leading space or remove trailing space or both of them. Okay. So these were all about the leading and trailing, these were all about the string functions in SQL. So let us discuss these functions using example. So in the previous video, I have shown you that one table is already created and name of the table is sample. So we will execute all the queries on that particular table. Okay. So first I will show you upper function. Show you that what was the content of our table. Okay, so here you can see that this is the content of our table product. So you can see that all the item names I have entered in lowercase form. So let us convert these letters into uppercase. So for that you may use upper function or you may use UCase function also. Okay, both will work same. So we want to change which column, we want to change item name column. So okay, what it will do with it, let us see. It will convert. Okay, let me write the original column name also so that we can compare the function as well as the original column. Remember, whatever function we are going to use, this function doesn't change the existing data. If we are using UCase in the on the column item name, it doesn't mean that all the item name will be converted to capital letter in the original table. In the original table, the item's name will be in the their original form only. Okay, the output we are getting will be in this modified form. For example, when we will execute this one, let us see In the original table, these will remain in lowercase letters, but this function will make all these letters in uppercase. Similarly, lcase will make all of them lowercase. Okay, so already we are having our string in lowercase, so no need to check that one. Let us move to the third function, that is length function. So what it will give you, it will give you the number of characters present in each item name. Okay, so let us execute this. Yes, see, eraser is having 6 number of characters, sharpener is having 9 number of characters. So like that, it will count all the characters of a particular string. Okay, now we will move to another function, and let us use left function. Suppose I want that from left side of all the item name, let us subtract 2 characters. So what it will do, bete? From eraser it will give us what? E and R. From sharpener it will give us SH. From ruler it will give RU, like that. So let us execute and check the result. You can see that from leftmost side we are getting how many number of characters? 2 number of characters. Why? Because we have mentioned the specified number of characters. Similarly, if you want from right side, if you want to extract 3 number of characters or any number of characters you want, then let us see what we are getting. Now see, we are getting from right side 3 number of characters. So from eraser we are having SER, from sharpener we are having NER, like that. In all the result we will have 3 number of characters from the right side. Okay, so next one is bete mid function. Now so left function will extract from left hand side, right function will extract from right hand side. What if we want to specify where should be the start position and how many characters we want to be extracted? So for that particular we are having mid function. Now suppose I want that from second characters I want to extract 2 number of characters. So what will happen, bete? From eraser what should be the expected output, bete? It will give you from the second position 2 number of characters. So which is the second position? From R. It will give you R and A. Okay, let us see what is the output. Now see, it is giving R A because we have mentioned that from second position. So second position is R in case of eraser, it is H in case of sharpener, and how many characters from that starting position? 2 characters. Okay, you want, if you want to change it, if you want to take 3 characters, then write it like this and execute this, so you will have 3 characters. So basically it means that bete mid function is going to take 3 arguments. First one, it will take the string. Second one, it will take the start position. And third one, it will take the number of characters. So if you will skip any of, suppose if you will skip this one, what it will do? It will give you all the characters starting from the second position. Let us skip this one and check what will be the result, because we have not mentioned the third parameter. So it will start from the second one and it will give you up to the last characters. Let us execute this one, bete. Now see, it started from the second position and up to last it is returning the value. Okay, so this was mid function. Now the next function, left function, right function, mid function, we have already done. Then the last one, which is left out, is bete instr function. Now what it will do? It will search for a particular substring in our string. For example, if you want to search that whether A is present in our item name or not, so you have to write, you have to mention the substring. Okay, so let us search. If the substring will be present in the string, then it will return that particular position, and if it is not present, it will return 0. For example, we are searching A in all the item names. So eraser we are having, yes, A. So what is the position? 1, 2 and 3. Okay, similarly in sharpener we are having A, the position is 3, and for the other's name we don't have A, so the result is 0. Let us search for R, bete. Okay, so now see, here R is present twice, here also, here also. So you have to remember that it will return the first occurrence. So result will be what, bete? 2. Okay, it will not be 6 because it will give you the position of the first occurrence. So let us execute this and see we are getting 2 because it will return the position of the first occurrence of the substring. Now let us search for RA. What it will do, Bete? Suppose we want to search RA, or let us search for PE. Okay, so it will search PE in the original string. Now here P is not present, so it will give you 0. Here P is present, so it will give you the position of P. So it will give you 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. Similarly, here we are also having PE. So what it will give you, Bete, result? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Remember to count space always, Bete, because space is also a character. So all the spaces and all the special symbol will also be counted as character. So let us execute this one. Now see, here 5 is there, here 8 is there, okay. Similarly, you will have the output. Remember, it will give you the first occurrence. If the P is repeated in your string, then it will give you the position of the first occurrence of your substring. And next functions are Bete, ltrim, rtrim, trim. So I have not entered any space here in between the item name. So those functions cannot be used here. So I hope that those three functions may be clear to all of you. So still, if you are having any doubt, you can ask me. So these were all about Bete string functions, and till now we have discussed single row functions. Okay, in the upcoming video we will discuss aggregate functions or multiple row functions. So thank you for watching, Bete. Take care.